Hello friends, in this video we will see how we can paint idli vada sambar and chutney in watercolors. Now it may be possible that some of you may not know what idli sambar is. Idli and sambar are dishes which are normally eaten for breakfast in South India. In the same way, vada, which resembles a donut but is not sweet, it is a little spicy and a bit salty, is often used along with idlis as breakfast item in South India. It's not only in South India but elsewhere in India as well as many parts of the world where Indian population exists. So let us see how we can paint idli vada sambar. Now these idlis are essentially tablet shape and they are sort of spongy, and the vada is with a hollow in the middle and resembles a donut in appearance. Then there are two bowls in which one carries the sambar, which is a kind of a gravy and also a little hot and spicy, plus there can be a green colored chutney along with the items. Now all these items are placed in some steel bowls and a steel plate, and we begin painting in watercolors with the help of Payne's Grey. Payne's Grey is heavily diluted and is used to paint the steel bowls and the steel plate. Let us see how we go about. So I apply the Payne's Grey on one side and then on the other side of the steel bowl. Then I wash the brush and I add some water in the middle portion and allow the color to just kiss the layer of water both ways. This gives rise to the bowl sort of shining in the middle. Then I add a little moisture on this side, on the bottom round corner of the bowl. Then I continue adding the color on the plate. then we allow this work done to dry completely. Then continue using the same Payne's Grey, rather dull, to paint the inner sides of the bowls. Now, once touch dry, you may paint the inner areas of the plate. This time using a little heavier Payne's Grey. Add the tone and soften it with the help of a little moist brush. Allowing some white paper to be left out, which resembles the shine of the steel plate. Idlis are white in color and therefore must remain protected throughout the painting process. Continue adding the Payne's Grey and keep softening it in the central area to indicate maximum light falling on the plate. I paint the sambar, which is red-orange in color. Protecting the spoon, which seems to be dipped in the sambar. Next, the chutney is green in color, and I combine a little bit of yellow with green. To produce the green color of the chutney. Overall, the recipe looks very appetizing and colorful. No wonder then that the millions of people in India as well as abroad, they enjoy the idli vada sambar for their breakfast. And of course, me too. Now coming to the idlis. The idlis are white in color and therefore ought to be painted by only suggesting the shadow areas with extremely diluted Payne's gray, almost water. Truly speaking, idlis are tasteless, odorless, colorless, and yet they form a very major item for Indian breakfasts. So I've just added water and a little touch of Payne's gray at the base to show it a little fluffy. It's made of rice. Then I allow this idli to completely dry. Upon drying, I add a hint of Payne's gray, and continue the same way as I did for the idli on top. Once again, allow this idli to dry fully. Now, coming to the medu vada, which resembles somewhat the donut, it is also a circular piece with a hollow in the middle. The color is a little yellow red, and so I make use of some yellow ochre, and I place the yellow ochre here and there along with touches of red, allowing the red to mingle into the yellow ochre. Add the yellow ochre on the top of the crescent. Add a few touches of red here and there. allowing lot of water to make the colors mingle freely amongst each other. Add touches of some heavy burnt sienna on the lower portion of the eatable. As also on the inner side of the hollow. Take up some Payne's Grey and put it right in the middle so as to make the hollow look more deep. When it comes to painting, generally we quickly think of landscapes or portraits or at times some abstracts, but little do we know that there is so much hidden in odd subjects like eatables, which can give you a lot of joy as you paint them. So there we are with wonderful two white idlis and a medu vada for breakfast. Now we allow this to completely dry. In this chutney, I add touches of Payne's Grey dots, that too in clusters, so as to indicate what we call the rye which is at times scattered and in places it appears to be in clusters. These are the mustard seeds. Often they are in plenty and scattered all over in the green chutney. Then we use the same heavy Payne's Grey to indicate the shadow cast by this bowl onto the plate. We may also indicate the shadow cast by the sambar bowl onto the plate. As also the shadow cast by the upper idli onto the lower one, but a little dilute this time. Then we continue adding the shadows situated deep inside between the idli and the vada. As also the shadow cast by the vada onto the plate. Softening. And again some Payne's grey to indicate the shadow cast by the lower idli onto the plate. Then allow this to completely dry. That was the inside edge. Again, allow the whole thing to dry completely, after which we'll put in the background.